Hello and thank you for joining us for Consumer Confidential Holiday Handbook Edition. I'm Vicky Nguyen. It's hard to believe, but the holiday season is upon us. So is this really the most wonderful time of the year, or is it the most stressful? I mean, honestly, it's probably both. But the good news, we're going to get through this together as I walk you through everything from avoiding travel hassles to serving an unforgettable holiday feast. Most importantly, we're going to help you celebrate the season by maximizing your buying power during these tricky economic times.
It's a holiday season like no other as consumers face record inflation, with 70% of shoppers saying they're wary of holiday spending. Nearly 33% of shoppers plan to buy fewer gifts this year, while roughly one quarter said they would opt for cheaper or more practical gifts such as gas cards. And when it comes to toys,
per item, you're only looking at maybe a $2 to $5 increase. But when you're looking at your overall toy shopping and buying for multiple kids, that can add up really quickly.
This year, the pressure is really on to snag those deals. Retailers are responding by earlying up holiday sales and discounting excess inventory caused by last year's supply chain issues.
A lot of items are kind of unexpected, like so much casual clothing. We're seeing furniture. We're seeing TVs.
About a quarter of Americans are already shopping for Thanksgiving and the holiday season, and there's a lot of momentum going into this time.
And despite a hectic summer for airline passengers,
some 4,000 flights have been delayed.
More than half of Americans plan to travel over the holiday season, with 30% flying.
Americans are preparing to crowd the nation's roads and airports again for another busy holiday season.
But the journey may be rocky as travelers face fewer flight options, high fuel costs, and staffing shortages. Prices for holiday travel expected to be the highest we've seen since before the pandemic.
Generally speaking, last-minute fares go in one direction, and it is always up.
But consumers are keeping spirits bright, taking advantage of more flexible work to travel during off-peak days, and finding ways to stretch their dollars in the hopes of making this the most wonderful time of the year.
We'll get to those travel hacks and holiday deals in just a moment. But first, let's focus on finances. Staying on budget and not going into debt during the holidays is always a challenge. And this year, with inflation, it's probably going to be even easier to overspend. So we have with us money expert Kristen O'Keefe Merrick. She is with O'Keefe Financial Partners. She's going to join us and give us some great tips to stay on budget. Kristen, great to have you.
Good to see you. Yeah.
So first question, what is your number one piece of advice before we even head out to the stores to help us rein in our spending?
Yeah, I like a macro strategy. Yeah. I love a good checklist. I think, and I've already done this, is, you know, sit down, however you make your list, hand, type, whatever it works for you, and make a full who you're buying gifts for.
Yeah.
Are you entertaining? Are you throwing a little party for the kids? Whatever that looks like.
Okay.
Then you want to be thoughtful about, can you map this out over the next couple of months, right? We don't have to spend all the money in December.
All at once, right.
Right? It's November. We can think about being thoughtful about buying wrapping paper now, ordering your Christmas card now, thinking about buying a few gifts here and there when you're at the store, and really being thoughtful about when the spend is happening so that your January credit card bill doesn't crush you.
No, I like that. Spreading it out. And also, you're right. You've got to make a comprehensive list so you know exactly what you're in for and who can fall off the list.
Who can fall off.
How do you do that without feeling guilty about it and also maybe signaling to friends and family, we're going to do Christmas a little differently this year.
Exactly. And I think it's tough to do it with your kids, right? Especially if Santa is still actively involved in gift giving, then I think you have to be really thoughtful about how you manage your expectations with your children. But, you know, Uncle Bobby can be told, hey, we're doing Christmas a little different. Here is a jar of jam that I made for you because it's from my heart, as opposed to a sweater that I had to spend $70 on. And I think that's where managing expectations becomes really important, both, you know, your spouses, your parents, your siblings, people who are going to understand your financial situation and be okay with not getting a big fancy gift.
And be direct. Have that conversation up front early so that everyone's on the same page. That's great advice.
Yes.
Talk to us about using cash versus credit cards, because we see these interest rates. They're going up and up and up. The Fed has signaled they're going to continue to go up. Where do you stand on shopping just with cash?
Yeah, I love shopping with cash. Mm-hmm. And it doesn't have to be like you go to the ATM and take out $1,000. You just use your debit card when you're walking around as opposed to using your credit card. The worry that you wake up on January 1st in debt from Christmas is a really big bummer. It's a bummer to start 2023 that way.
Right.
So if you can be thoughtful about spending, like I said, cash throughout, And if you can avoid credit, do so. For the love of God, do so.
It's, right.
You know, rates are, APRs on credit cards these days could be up to 25%. That's not a small amount of interest. And so that adds up, that compounds. The other thing is you can make payments to your credit cards as you go.
Okay.
So
to help keep that interest down so you're not
yeah,
paying money.
Throw $100 at it once a week, and that way when the January bill comes, it's less than you have anticipated.
One last quick question. What do consumers need to know about these little microloans? They're buy now, pay later plans. You see them popping up online. Some are even offered at the point of sale in person. What should we know before we say, yes, I'd like to buy now and pay later?
Yeah, I think that there's a place for buy now, pay later in our life. I think I would recommend if you use it for a big ticket item that you wouldn't normally be able to afford. For instance, if you have to replace a refrigerator or a washing machine and you don't have that cash up front, you can utilize buy now, pay later, because what happens is it sets you on a payment plan. And most of the time, these buy now, pay laters do not accumulate interest.
Yeah.
But they do impact your credit report, which is incredibly important to know. And they also can catch up with you if you're not thoughtful about how you're paying them on time. And also, like, what happens if you have three loans going at once? What if you have four? Don't buy boots with buy now, pay later.
Got it.
Right?
So no impulse buys, no consumer type goods. Save it for the big items.
Yes, big items only.
All right. Money expert Kristen O'Keefe.
Good to see you.
Good to see you. Thank you so much. With high inflation, secondhand goods may become a popular option for presents this year, but buyer beware. Criminals are also taking notice, and they're trying to take advantage of those bargain hunters. What you need to know so you're not ripped off.
For holiday shoppers in a season of high inflation, online marketplaces can be a great place to find bargains. Unfortunately, police say peer-to-peer sites like Facebook Marketplace and OfferUp are also being used by scammers and violent criminals.
9 times out of 10, if you see a deal that's too good to be true, it is.
Chicago police are investigating dozens of robberies over the past few months, the suspects using online listings to lure in would-be buyers.
The offenders will contact them via cell phone and tell them to go to another location. And when they go to that area, four multiple offenders will show up, display guns, and take not only the money that they have in their pockets, but sometimes vehicles, watches, you know, wallets, that type of thing.
It's a trend law enforcement officials say has been growing nationwide. In Houston, police releasing this video of a robbery earlier this year. They say the suspects posed on Facebook Marketplace as potential car buyers. In Florida and Detroit, similar cases of suspects accused of robbing individuals selling Air Jordans and iPhones. Authorities say criminals are most likely to target high-end items like designer purses, all-terrain vehicles, scooters, Apple iPads, and watches. To stay safe, officials say always use safe exchange locations, including in some cities, inside the lobby of a police station.
And the police are okay with that?
That's what we want them to do, especially now the holidays are quickly approaching. We don't want anyone to trade their safety for a great deal.
Experts say online marketplaces are also targeted by hackers and scam artists who use fake accounts and listings to steal your money. Common red flags include the seller refusing to meet in person or let you see the item before purchase. The seller's profile shows the same item located in different states. The seller asking for gift cards instead of cash. Facebook says it takes the threat of scams seriously and has specialized detection tools and trained enforcement and review teams working to remove bad actors from the platform. OfferUp says it also has a team of investigators who look to remove bad items and users from its site and provides in-app tools for identity verification. Facebook also allows users to set up a meeting plan within the app that can be shared with a group of trusted friends, all to ensure your hunt for deals doesn't put you in danger.
And Facebook says you should also be aware of buyers who are pushing you to make that sale quickly, or if they try to contact you outside of the app. Always try to meet up during the day in a public location. And another way to protect yourself, experts say use a secure credit card or PayPal option whenever you can. Those offer additional fraud protection. And remember, if someone is offering a price that's far lower than market value, that is a big red flag. Coming up, we'll have the 411 on holiday travel, from finding deals to dealing with crowds and cancellations. What you need to know about going home for the holidays. Later, skimp, splurge, or swap. How to pull off that unforgettable feast without going broke. You're watching Consumer Confidential on Today All Day. This year, 113 million travelers are expected to hit the road and the skies for holiday trips. That means busier airports and higher travel costs due to inflation. Here to help us navigate the season ahead is Alicia Prakash. She's the Associate Editorial Director at Travel and Leisure Magazine. Alicia, welcome.
Thank you
for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Everyone wants to know, what are your top tips to make travel this holiday season as stress-free as possible?
Yeah, so these days, new travel regulations and short-staffed airports can really lead to long lines when checking bags or going through airport security. Mm-hmm. So I always say it's best to err on the side of caution and arrive at the airport early.
Okay.
You know, getting to the airport at least 2 hours in advance is always a good idea, but that's especially true during the holiday season mm-hmm. to avoid any added stress. Similarly, if you're driving to see loved ones, you know, you'll want to allot extra travel time for traffic. Apps like Waze can be incredibly useful tools for gauging traffic conditions, mm-hmm. Not only before you hit the road, but once you're driving. So definitely recommend downloading that as well. Now, if you haven't already booked your flights, mm-hmm. I do recommend opting for an early morning flight
yeah.
as well as a direct flight. This will help you avoid any delays with layovers, and in the event that your flight does get canceled, there will be hopefully plenty of options for you to rebook on throughout the day.
A couple of questions. We're all going to be together, so any tips for dealing with crowds specifically? And then what happens if your flight is delayed or it is canceled? Walk me through the process of getting your money back.
Sure. So if you are truly looking to escape those crowds this holiday season, it pays to be flexible with your travel date.
Okay.
So, you know, looking to arrive a day or two earlier and returning a day early or late can really help you save money as well as avoid those crowds.
Like, don't go on the peak days.
Exactly. You might also want to opt for a smaller airport that's nearby rather than a main hub. So, you know, for example, fly into Long Beach Airport instead of LAX.
Yeah.
These smaller airports tend to have less demand, so they offer lower prices and fewer crowds. But mm-hmm. either way, if you're flying, download the MyTSA app, okay. which offers information on airport security wait times. So, you know, you can monitor for the hubs that you'll be flying and then plan accordingly.
And what do people need to know when their flight is delayed or canceled?
Yeah, great question. So, you know, hopefully all runs smoothly. However, first and foremost, you'll want to consider third-party sites like mm-hmm. FlightAware to monitor your flight for any potential delays or cancellations. You know, in the event that your flight is unfortunately canceled, your airline will likely rebook you on a new flight. If for some reason that route doesn't work for your travel schedule, though, call your airline. You know, talking to a customer service agent really provides you with flexibility to get the rebooking that you want. And one tip I really love is call your airline's international hotline.
Yes.
You know, most
I heard
US,
about this.
Yeah, so most U.S. passengers will call the main
the domestic
U.S.
line, yeah.
Yep. And while that's a great option, you'll likely endure longer waits.
Mm-hmm.
So try calling your foreign office. And, you know, the agents there, you'll likely get through faster, and the agents there will be able to help you just the same.
Right. They speak English.
Yep.
Let's talk about gear. What are the best pieces of luggage or bags? What do you like to travel with?
Yeah, so, well, first and foremost, I'll say I am team carry-on. So
yeah.
if you can, pack a carry-on
pack
only
light.
To reduce your chances of losing any luggage along the way. You know, it's also a great idea so that you can bypass the baggage carousel on your way out so you can breeze
yeah.
right through the airport when you land. But if you are checking a bag, take a picture of your suitcase.
Mm.
This can really help you get compensated in the event that your bag does get lost or, you know, it does arrive at your destination but arrives damaged.
I have about 30 seconds. What's your best tip for booking hotels?
Yeah, so I would say If you haven't yet booked your hotels, compare prices on sites like Booking.com and Expedia to find a price that's right for you and your budget. Interestingly, the platform you use can also make a difference. So, you know, if you're on mobile, whether you're in app or browser, the prices might appear lower there than they would when you're on desktop.
Interesting.
And yeah, and that's because some aggregator sites will offer app-only promotions in order to entice their users to download and use their app. So definitely consider that as well.
Alicia Prakash with Travel and Leisure. Thank you so much, Alicia.
Yep, thank you for having me.
And when we come back, Cyber Monday, Black Friday, those are bargain hunting days, but are you really getting a deal? And skimp, splurge, or swap, where to go big at the grocery aisle for your holiday feast? Consumer Confidential is coming right back. If you have started your holiday shopping, chances are you have already seen signs for deep discounts. But should you snap up those deals right away? Kevin Bressler is the executive editor at Consumers Checkbook. It's a nonprofit with a mission to help consumers get the best service and lowest prices. Kevin, that's music to our ears, especially right now.
Yeah.
Welcome. So let's talk about this study that y'all did. It's not even Thanksgiving, but we have been seeing since October that many stores have been comparing their deals to Black Friday sales, saying shop early, shop often, you're going to get great discounts.
Right.
What did you actually find when you compared prices across a whole bunch of stores?
Yeah, actually, when I woke up this morning, there were two junk emails waiting for me saying Black Friday starts now at a few major retailers. I really urge folks to not worry so much about the timing of these things. Don't think, oh, I'd better jump on this quote-unquote deal now or it's going to go away. Mm-hmm. We've been tracking prices at major retailers for years. We recently completed a study where we looked at 25 major retailers over 33 weeks. We checked in on their prices once a week and found that almost all of them these days are guilty of holding what we call misleading sales, where, you know, the sales, these supposed discounts never end, that week after week when we checked in, these prices, these products were listed as being on sale. But what they're doing is essentially they're crossing out a price, a list or regular price, that they rarely, if ever, charge so that they can tell you that they're selling it for 20% off, 40% off, 60% off.
So it's like a perma sale. It's just always happening, and you think, okay, I'm getting a better deal. But in some cases, it never was at that regular price.
Right. And in many cases, these stores never charged that list price or at least, you know, only charged it for 10 minutes or for a few hours or something. I think that, you know, these are misleading sales. We call them fake sales.
Sure.
It's an attempt to get you to not shop around, to make you think,
you gotta do it now, act now, buy now.
And by now, you know, if it says it's 60% off, what's your inclination is to say, well, they're practically giving it away. Right. Why would I bother shopping?
There is a real psychology to it. So, okay, you found this. You looked at 25 stores, 33 weeks. What is the best way then to know if a sale really is a sale and if this really is the good time to buy that item?
Right. Don't be pressured. Okay. Don't think, okay, if I don't do this right now, this deal's going to go away, because that's rarely the case. We rarely found that, you know, prices dip below a certain threshold for very long and that you really, if you hadn't jumped on something, you would have lost out.
Okay.
You know, stores, some of them even on their websites have countdown clocks now. That's to get you to ramp up the anxiety, to make sure that, you know, that you buy then and there without shopping around. So the key is to shop around.
Okay, Just compare prices, shop around.
Make sure you can't get a better price somewhere else. Do a quick internet search to see if other major retailers are offering it for less.
Sometimes I'll just search it right there in the store.
There you go. And if you're in the store, you can even use apps that let you scan barcodes, and they'll do comparison shopping for you. There are price shopping bots out there. There's a few that we've tried that seem to work okay. Or Price Grabber has one. Yahoo Shopping has one. There are, you know, extensions you can add to your web browser that will, like, called Honey. Mm-hmm. It will look around to see if there are coupon codes that can apply or maybe better deals other places. I'll tell you, none of these things are perfect,
right?
None of them work great. But overall, the key is to just make sure you do some shopping around before you buy, especially if it's a big ticket item.
Kevin, what are you finding in terms of stores and their willingness to do two important things? One, price match. Are stores generally willing to price match if you find a better price and can show it to them? And two, are they willing to do price adjustments more now than they have in the past?
Yeah, both those things, yes.
Okay, good.
Especially if you're in a store and you find that a competitor is charging less money for that item, most stores will price match. And it sounds like a pain, but our researchers have found that when they've tried to do it, it's quite easy. Somebody at the register can do it. Sometimes you have to go to customer service. But we found it was a pretty simple, straightforward process. Another thing you can do is, and this is even also kind of a pain, is that after you've bought something, if prices go down, and so you could have bought it for less at that retailer, you can usually go back and they'll go ahead and make an adjustment to your bill. You'll get a refund. Being nice goes a long way. It does, nice. Yeah. Okay. And you know, in a lot of these stores, they're set up, they're used to it, surprisingly. I mean, I just didn't think many people did this, but it was quite easy when we tried to get these adjustments made.
Kevin Brassler with Consumers Checkbook. Thank you so much for your time, Kevin.
Good to see you.
Well, next up, take the pressure off of your holiday meal. Enjoy the feast without the fuss. We're going to show you how to save time and money when Consumer Confidential comes right back. Well, it sure can feel like you have a lot on your plate when it comes to planning that holiday meal, especially this year with food prices going up. Have no fear. You can have that feast without the fuss. With me now to help walk us through it all is Real Simple Editor-in-Chief Lauren Iannotti. Lauren, welcome. Thank you so much for being here with us on Consumer Confidential. So let's talk a little bit about the big holiday coming up.
Yeah.
Where turkey is the star, and turkey prices we know are up 73% from last year. It's expensive. So what are your best tips in terms of how you can save on the staples and still have a wonderful meal? Where can we skimp? Where should we splurge? Where should we swap?
Sure. Okay. Don't buy the breast. Don't buy the whole bird. Buy the legs. So we actually, our main event this year, I know it's a little bit crazy, and I remember talking to my food director, and she's like, this is nuts.
Legs.
They're much cheaper because they're less in demand. Mm-hmm. They're totally delicious. It's dark meat.
Yeah, dark meat.
Yeah, and absolutely. And we have a great recipe for them. And they can be just as delicious as anything else. So I just say that's where you're going to save right there. If you go for the legs instead. Also, they're also like a pound each or a pound and a half, which basically takes some of the hard math out of figuring
it
out.
Like how many people gets a leg?
One leg per person.
Oh,
absolutely.
I love that. Okay.
Stuffing. Don't worry about using dried spices. You absolutely can use dried spices. You can use the spices that are in your cupboard right now. Just anything. I know a lot of recipes call for fresh, right?
Right.
And you feel like, oh, I got to do that. Nope. You can use dried. Okay. 1 tablespoon of fresh equals 1 teaspoon of dried.
Got it. Okay.
I was very careful not to mix that up. I don't want people poisoning their relatives.
Too much rosemary.
Exactly. So, and if you want to get fresh, absolutely don't worry about wasting because there are ways to preserve them and save them. You basically cut them like fresh cut flowers, the leftovers, and put them in a glass on the counter. And they can stay for a couple of days. Just change the water every day. And then, you know, if you're worried about still not using them, just chop them up and put them in an ice cube tray with olive oil. I love this trick. Put it in the freezer. And then you've got these little flavor bombs you can put in soups and stews and sauces.
Yes. Okay, that's a great tip. What about beverages? Those tend to add up. They get pricey. Yep. What are your tips on saving there?
So don't feel like you have to have a varietal of wine for every single person. Like Uncle Doug really likes that Cote de Rhone. Well, then he can bring it. Your job is to get one red and one white. Crowd pleasers. They don't have to be expensive. If you talk to your wine shop, they'll have good bottles for like $12 a bottle. And the more you buy, the cheaper it is. So if you get a case, if you have a big crowd coming, one red, a medium-bodied red that goes nicely with your turkey.
Yeah.
One white, let's say a Sancerre, a nice acidic Sancerre, a Sauvignon Blanc that goes nicely with your turkey, and they get to choose, and you're done.
I like that. You know, people did that for weddings, too, because if you have an open bar, it can be really crazy, but if you just choose a few select drinks, nobody really even feels like they're missing out.
Totally.
Let's talk about the grocery store. Where can we cut costs? What should we be keeping an eye out when it comes to bargains?
So the big thing about saving at the grocery store, and we know it's tough out there. I mean, the prices are skyrocketing. Plan early. I like to say shop early, shop often.
Yeah.
First, set your menu. List up what you're going to have to buy. Perishables versus non-perishables. Non-perishables you're going to hold off on. Right now, we've got a couple weeks till Thanksgiving. We're talking about looking out for sales.
Mm-hmm.
If you have time, you can comparison shop.
You can.
So you look for things on sale. Sign up for your store's points card or points.
Yeah, the loyalty program.
And the rewards. I don't know what you've been waiting for, but if you haven't done it yet,
do it now.
You'll get deals. They'll let you know about deals that others don't get. And then there are also apps that you can sign up for, or you can, load up on your phone. And it's Basket. And the other one that we really like is Flip with two peas.
Yep. Flip with two peas.
And they will do the comparison shopping for you. They're like you're going through your circulars for you, basically, and telling you where the best deals are and how to get to them.
I got 20 seconds. What about cooking? Best tip there.
Oh, my God. I guess make ahead. I map it out and I write it down. Here, actually, my best tip is write it down because you don't have to keep deciding over and over again. You know what you're making on Wednesday. You know what you're making on Thursday. You have to spread it all out. You have to make sure you're preparing and making things ahead, and you will have the best Thanksgiving ever.
I love it. Great tips. Lauren Iannotti with Real Simple. We appreciate you. Thank you.
Thank you very much for having me.
That is going to be our time for now. Catch me on NBC News Now weekdays from 12 to 2 Eastern. For all of us here at NBC News, I'm Vicky Nguyen. Be sure to join me for another edition of Consumer Confidential right here on Today All Day.
Hey, thanks for watching our YouTube channel. Find your favorite recipes, celebrity interviews, uplifting stories, shop our favorite deals, and so much more with the Today app. Download it now.